In this learning module, we will perform a high-level overview of topics covered under the umbrella of relationships and predictions. These include the addition of lines and curves to visualizations, the application of the data relationships tool to perform pairwise comparisons, and the construction of predictive models through the use of regression modeling or classification modeling options. We will begin by discussing in detail the capabilities which are presented in the Lines and Curves section of the Visualization Properties dialog. The Add button provides a drop-down list of options, which we can divide into two groups, those which are calculated based upon data in the visualization, and those which are simply drawn based upon fixed values or expressions. Horizontal and vertical lines present a variety of submenu options, which include straight lines drawn from fixed values or calculated based upon data represented in the visualization. Line from data table draws a line for each value in a column, and these columns can be selected from any data table. Average and plus or minus one standard deviation generates three calculated lines. The curve draw menu option will draw a line based upon an expression. However, if you want the expression to include values from a data table column, you will need to choose curve from data table from beneath the add menu. Line from column values draws a line based upon x and y coordinates provided in columns, which again may be selected from any data table. And the remaining options are curve fitting options, which are all calculated based upon the data presented in the visualization. Several of these algorithms allow you to adjust settings or fix values in order to direct the fit to your data or the projection of future values. Let's take a look at a few of these options in a quick demonstration. Use Open File to navigate to the example with Relationships and Predictions Overview in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. This example is based upon a simple data table where product sales information was collected from 220 customers. We sell six different product types, labeled A through F, and both the total sales of that product type, as well as my sales of that product type to that customer, have been captured. Additional descriptive information for each sale in the form of the profit margin and negotiated discount applied to the sale are provided, as well as a count of the number of sales calls the customer has experienced. Finally, customers may be identified as a preferred customer or not. On the next page, the values in that data table have been represented in different visualization types. Notice that each of the plots includes lines and curves. This bar chart fits the data with a polynomial curve fit, while this bar chart fits the data to a Gaussian curve. In the scatter plot, a straight line has been added which fits the data using a linear regression algorithm, and two dashed lines have been added at fixed points in order to subdivide the plot into quadrants. Note that if we filter out data, the calculated curve fit values will adjust to the limited data in the plots, while the lines drawn at fixed points remain in place. Similarly, when dragging and dropping product type on the scatter plot as a trellis variable, the calculated straight line fit adjusts to the data within each trellis panel, while the drawn horizontal and vertical lines remain in the same positions. In addition to using lines to evaluate potential relationships between data columns, there's a tool which is designed specifically to examine a large number of pairwise relationship comparisons between columns of data in our data table. The Data Relationships tool can compare columns using a variety of algorithms. You may compare numerical columns in order to determine if they are related, or numerical versus categorical columns in order to evaluate differences between groups of values. You may also compare the distribution of data across two categorical groupings. Two algorithms are available for numerical versus numerical comparisons, as well as numerical versus categorical comparisons. These algorithms can be categorized as parametric and non-parametric statistical tests. Parametric statistical tests make an assumption about the distribution and variance of the numerical data, while non-parametric tests treat the numerical values in a rank order fashion and therefore do not make such assumptions. Finally, the categorical versus categorical comparison is performed with only a single test option. Each of these options involves you selecting which columns will serve as X and Y values for these pairwise comparisons and will result in a table of metrics showing the comparison results, as well as a dynamic visualization or two which allows you to view the details of each pairwise comparison. Let's return to our demonstration. On the tab titled Data Relationships, all three column comparison options have been applied. The numerical versus numerical results, displayed here, include a table of metrics resulting from the application of pairwise linear regression comparisons. The scatter plot is tied to this table, such that marking a different row of data will display the associated pairwise comparison in the plot. The table has been sorted such that the comparisons with the highest correlations, or negative correlations, are displayed at the top. The numerical versus categorical result also generates a table of metrics, resulting from the ANOVA calculation and an associated visualization. Clicking on different rows shows the box plot which corresponds to the comparison indicated by the marked row. In this table of metrics, lower p-values are found at the top of the table. Finally, the categorical versus categorical comparison results show a table of metrics from the chi-squared test and associated frequency distribution table for each pairwise comparison. Again, lower p-values appear at the top of the table. While data relationship comparisons allow you to discover and evaluate relationships between columns, the predictive modeling tools allow you to use those relationships between existing columns in order to predict values which are not currently available. Two types of predictive models are available: regression modeling and classification modeling. Regression modeling is useful for making numerical predictions, and classification modeling is useful for making predictions for categorical assignments. Regression modeling will provide two models to choose from, depending upon whether it is more appropriate to apply parametric or non-parametric statistical methods to your data. While linear regression is a parametric method which models the numeric response column as a weighted sum of the predictor columns, regression tree is a non-parametric method that creates a binary tree by recursively splitting the data on the predictor values. Likewise, classification modeling will provide two models from which to choose. The logistic regression method is a parametric method which is used when the response column is categorical with only two possible values. The probability of the possible outcomes is modeled with a logistic transformation as a weighted sum of the predictor columns. The classification tree method, on the other hand, can handle response variables with more than two classes. This non-parametric method creates a binary tree by recursively splitting the data on the predictor values. All of these models are executed using the TIBCO Enterprise Runtime for R, or TER statistical engine, which is based upon the R statistical language. Although you can use these tools without knowing anything about TER or R, understanding that these methods are based upon R statistics may be helpful as you seek to obtain more details about each of these algorithms. For example, you might type R linear regression rather than just linear regression if you wanted to perform an internet search to learn more about the underlying statistics supporting that method. When any of these algorithms are applied within the TIBCO Spotfire environment, it is expected that you will implement the predictive modeling process by fitting the model to a specified training data table, evaluating the model on a separate validation data table, and then make predictions based upon new data which is supplied to the model, which will generate that coveted new column of values. Let's return to our demonstration one more time. On the tab titled Tables for Prediction, the customers in the original data table we worked with in this demonstration have been randomly divided into two separate data tables, one which has been used to train predictive models, and the other which has been used to validate predictive models. A third data table contains information for 25 new customers. However, note that my product sales figures and the assignment to preferred customer status are currently not available. Using predictive models which have already been created and evaluated, we can use the Insert menu to insert predicted columns. First, we will use a model built using regression modeling, which is intended to predict my product sales. It will use this existing data from each of the 25 new customers, and when we click OK, you can see the result added as a predicted column, speculating the amount of my product sales for each customer, based on those predictor values. If we return to the Insert Predicted Columns menu and select a different model, this one which has been built using classification modeling, it will again use this existing data from our 25 new customers to predict which of those customers are to achieve preferred customer status. When we click OK, you can see additional columns added to the new customers table, one which contains values of yes or not yes as the prediction of preferred customer status. Please note that adding predicted columns, as we have just done here, is the last step of a process. The first step involves building the model using the training data table and evaluating a series of diagnostics to determine what parameters should be included in the model. The next step is to evaluate the model using the validation data table, where the predicted results can be compared to actual results. Again, diagnostic metrics and visualizations are provided in order to help you determine the accuracy of your model and ensure that you can use the model to predict data with the appropriate level of confidence in your results.